Hey loves, welcome back to my channel. If it's your first time here, hi, my name is Sarah, and if you're returning, thank you so much for coming back. So today's video is going to be a chit chat video on friendships. I'm also going to be installing this hair. I'm going to be showing you guys how I installed this hair. This is a closure wig from Miss Lynn Hair. In this video, I showed you guys how I installed this hair and how I straightened it, how I made the top flat and all of that, and my thoughts about this hair. It is a 14 inch 250% density hair, and yeah, I'm going to leave all the details in the description box below. This is honestly the perfect everyday hair if you ask me. Anyway, if you want to see me install this hair and then listen to me talk about friendships, then keep watching.
Hey guys, this is Sarah from the future. So I was basically just showing you guys this hair here and showing you what it looks like before I put it on my hair. As you can see, this hair is moving, it's not stiff. Yes. Anyway, so I'm going to put up the video I put up on my story on Instagram. If you're not following me, make sure you follow me. And then I asked you guys what your thoughts are on this video, and I shared a couple of you guys' opinions. And yeah, I'll just let you guys watch the video.
Something about friendships that took you forever to learn.
Girlfriend groups do not work. Don't believe these 30-second TikToks of girls in Miami, because look, there's a lot of things that happen behind the doors of a girl group. Number one, there are definitely favorites in the friend group, and half the time a lot of people follow that favorite person. Number two, there's always drama. Yeah. Number three, everyone talks shit about everyone. Like, it's almost as if like everyone secretly hates each other but still hang out with one another. It's weird. Number four, believe it or not, girls are haters, and there's going to be a lot of them in that friend group that is in competition with you. All them slick comments, yeah, they're not just jokes. Number five, I think. Vacation and boys can really bring out a person's true colors. So when they say Miami is the test of all true friendships, they're not lying. I just don't think girlfriend groups can work. It's too many personalities mixed in one. You're better off with a throuple or probably your own personal best friend. If you do have a lot of friends, just don't mix them all together, because a bunch of girls hanging out with each other is a recipe for disaster.
We're going to rock it like this, as opposed to like this, but I'm just going to come backwards. This person said, groups don't work. Just have distant friends who you hang out with from time to time.
Great.
And just so you know, like, I'm genuinely interested in learning, in getting to know about this topic, or getting to know about this, or hearing from people's experiences rather, because I'm in a phase of my life where I don't want to say trying to make friends, because I'm honestly not trying to make a lot of friends, but yeah, I'm kind of in that state in my life where I'm trying to like meet new people. Because if you don't know, from my life update video, I had a very bad experience with a friend that kind of just shut me out. I don't know if to say it just changed my perspective about friendships and about people. But honestly, you guys were so helpful in that comment section. It just opened my eyes to, because of one bad person doesn't mean there are a lot of bad people. Do you understand? Wow, this wig looks cute. It looks different. It kind of looks different from what I'll normally go for. Yeah, this is different. This is not Sarah. Yeah, but we're going to rock it regardless. Anyway, a couple of you guys were basically telling me that, oh, because I had one bad friendship doesn't mean like I should shut everything out. And of course, like, yes, that's true. That's actually very true. It shouldn't be like that. But to be honest, you can't deny the fact that like, that I'll be more mindful of the kind of people I let into my life, and I'll be more mindful of what I'm open about. For example, I won't just put my ATM password in front of anybody again, because with that person, I was kind of free. And like, when we go for stuff, 90%, 100% of the time when we go out for stuff, like, I was the one paying, and we're going out a lot, so I was the one paying, and I wasn't careful about putting my ATM password. I would just put it, and that was how this person had access to carry my ATM and clear my account. Yeah, so yeah, that's one thing I'll be more careful about this time around. Anyway, yeah, let me just keep reading. I didn't know I was diverting. The next person said, true, I got to really realize this because I was less social and honestly horrible. So sad. Facts, I have experienced this through high school and uni too. Next person said, I absolutely agree. I've been in a friend group and it's not as fun as it looks. Too much drama. sadly. And jealousy, if you have an issue with the queen bee, you're cut out. I feel like people should just have really close friends, two or three, and then build a relationship. The other ones can be people you're just cool with, but not friends. I think I get what she's saying. Somebody said, I've never had one. Sammy said, I've never had one, so I can't really say much. This is the same as me. So I don't have like a group of friends that all of us know that, oh, if one person is going out, we're all going out for all night. I don't have this kind of people. And she said, I just hang out with people, but never in a clique way. Same girl. When growth and development isn't going at the same time, there's bound to be jealousy. We mature differently. To be honest, all she said is true. At least 87.39%. What? Why did you say 87.39%? She said at least 87.39% because I've experienced it up to now and it's actually not cool. And most of the people here have had bad experiences, and from what I'm reading, it's almost like, oh, once you have a problem with the queen or the main person in the group, it's almost like you have a problem with everybody. So it's almost like everybody's worshiping that person. Ha! People used to try. I feel like if I'm ever in that kind of group, it's me that will be the queen. I'm joking. I honestly don't see myself in that kind of... I've been in a situation where I was friends with somebody and they low-key wanted to control me, or they wanted me to do whatever they wanted to. This was my first year of uni, and this person just wanted to, I don't know if to say, be my boss, be the person controlling me. And... before, I was somebody that was not very outspoken. No. I was somebody that, like, it's easy for me to move around because number one, I'm very shy, I was very shy. I don't think I'm as shy as I was before again. I was very shy and I was very, I don't know how to talk. I'm that kind of person that when I go to make my hair, they do rubbish and they say, do you like it? I'll say yes. And when I go home, I'll be complaining. Yeah, I was that person. I was that person that didn't know how to speak for herself. Like, I don't know how to speak if I don't like something. I don't know how to speak if I don't want something. Like, I'm just, yes, okay, no problem. I don't know if you guys get what I'm saying, but yeah, I was that person. So it was easy for this person to just control me around and think I could be whoever she wanted me to be. Hopefully I got out of that relationship and that friendship. Decision I ever made for my life, honestly, because it was honestly the best. Like, it was so bad to the point that this person would be sending me. When you knew, but you're sending me as if we're in secondary school. And you know that time, I wasn't fresh out of secondary school, but I hadn't had any experience of like uni, or I don't know how to explain it, Sha. Or it was just the kind of person I was. Like, I was just, I won't say anything. You tell me to do this, okay, I'll do it. Tell me to give you this, give me your this one, give me your that one. And I literally had to take a step back. Like, this person is literally using me. I don't know, I'm just diverting and giving examples from my own personal experiences. Yeah, so let's not divert too much. The next person said, she's speaking facts, I can't handle stress. Yes, I agree. I was in a group of six, filled with everyone gossiping and hating on each other. Wow, six or more. So it's like, I'm sure you gave yourselves a name. And if one person is not there, it'd be like, no, the group is not complete. Next one says, I'm not a fan of having girlfriend groups. It's just a lot to deal with. But I feel like people don't even plan for this kind of groups or this kind of friendship groups. I feel like they just happen. My opinion, I don't know. That's why it's important to keep this a group small as possible. The more the girls, the more havoc. I can't lie. Honestly, I feel like this one of having girlfriends or rather female friends is kind of true. No offense, but for me personally, I feel like I've just not had the best luck with friendships, honestly, because at that time, all the people that were my friends, or I thought were my friends, I feel like they were always my friends for something. I know one that was my friend for wig, one that was my friend for makeup, one that was my friend for I don't know, friends because of what you have or what they can get from you. Yes, that's it. That one, it's not cute. I'm just going to round up and read the remaining questions, the remaining responses. Somebody said, That's the worst thing you can ever do for yourself. It just doesn't work. It's too much drama. Okay. Then somebody said, my friend group is really different from what people say about friend groups. They are the best and we remove the bad ones that weren't adding value. This sounds like a gang thing. This, no offense, but this sounds like maybe one of the girls, one of the other girls complaining and saying if you have a problem with one person, they'll just remove you. This sounds like that. They're the best and we remove the bad ones that weren't working. So good and so happy for you that you finally found like people that you can actually vouch for, or people that like you guys actually care about. Somebody said it doesn't work for alpha females. There's usually a superior jealousy. Very true. I feel like, no offense, but I feel like this is so true. Like if you're an alpha female like I am, I like to believe that I am an alpha female. I don't think this kind of thing can work for me because I really don't have time. From the videos I've been watching, I keep hearing them say like something about 90% successful people is that they don't have a lot of friends, or they don't have like a friend group or a friend gang or whatever. That doesn't mean if you're in a friend group or a friend gang it can't work. No, that doesn't mean it won't work or it can't work, but it's just like from research it shows that like alpha females or people that are really successful usually have like really small groups. Doesn't mean if you have a group of friends you won't be successful. But I really agree with this girl's point, Sha. Sounds to me like she's had terrible experiences with friendships. Sounds to me like a lot of people have. My girl group is a mix of different personalities and it's crazy how we truly love each other. And she said, one, the youngest is 22 and the oldest is 30. Sounds interesting. I disagree, only if girls are not mature. They are kept for aesthetic purposes. Or maybe true for any type of friend group. It depends on the kind of friends. Yeah, I think it also depends on the kind of people, honestly, and the kind of personalities. You can't mix all crazy people in one friend group. That one is just, it's almost like a crazy boyfriend and a crazy girlfriend. When you are fighting, like, who will calm who down? I feel like it's all, we cannot be hot-headed. One has to be, like, calm. Who says friendship with one person can't still scatter? Friend groups are really fun with the right people. Who says friendship with just one person can't? Of course it can scatter. Personally, friend groups have done me more good than harm, so I'm an advocate for it. Sounds like you've been successful at it, champ. But yeah, I think she hasn't experienced healthy girl friendships and shouldn't generalize. True. I once had my girlfriend group back in uni. Long story short, it was the most toxic time of my life. Favoritism is there, but when you find the right people, a very small group is better. Okay, anyway, so I feel like in this life, we can't live our life based on people's opinions or based on what people think it should be like. It's almost like saying don't date a Yoruba girl. For example, Yoruba girls are crazy, Yoruba girls are this, Yoruba girls are that, but it's very possible that somebody is in a relationship with a Yoruba girl and is so perfect and he's having the time of his life. And I don't know if you guys get what I'm saying. What works for A might not work for B. So I've had a couple of people in this question box saying that friend groups work for them, and that's amazing and I'm so happy for them. And there are also some people that are highly against it because they've had bad experiences. Me personally, I just feel like it's something that will not work for me. I'm more of a small circle kind of person, or even if I'll have a lot of friends, I feel like I don't like to mix my friendships. Yeah. Yeah, so that's basically it. Let me know your thoughts in case you missed this in the question box. Let me know your thoughts, just let me know in the comment section below and it'll be fun. Make sure you check out Miss Lynn here. I'm going to leave all their links in the description box below. And yeah, this hair is a very good everyday hair. If you're looking for an everyday wig like me, I have one there, but I feel like everybody in this town knows me with that wig, so it's good that I have this one now. Thank you guys so much for watching and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.